So now today we are going to flash AEX 6.3 ROM on our Zeek Z2 Plus. So today's method is going to be a bit of different because today we are going to use our PC in order to change our TWRP version, and you need to flash another zip file which I'm going to show you, and that is vendor to factory zip file. So basically you need to flash this zip file if you have actually flashed any travel ROM before, and after that you need to flash the new TWRP which I'm going to link in the description below. So I'm going to show you the process. As you can see, there are two files, factory to vendor and vendor to factory. So you need to flash vendor to factory in order to flash AEX 6.3 successfully. So now you need to, as you know, I just flashed it before, so I'm not going to flash it. And after connecting it, and you need to boot into the fast boot mode, and I'm going to show you the process in your PC using the CMD, and you need to install the minimal fast boot folder, and so I'm going to show you where it is going to be installed. So going into the local disk C and going into the program files, as you can see now, getting into the program files, and there you will be able to see the folder of minimal ADB fastboot folder, and here you can see I have put my TWRP recovery file, and here is the CMD where you are going to write this command in order to flash new TWRP travel ROM version, and after flashing that version you will be able to flash AEX 6.3 ROM on your Zeek Z2 Plus successfully. So before writing the command, what you need to do is you need to boot your phone into fast boot mode, and so you need to restart your system, and then as you can see, just click on the button, volume up button, and then go to the fast boot mode, and as you can see we are into the fast boot mode, and now I'm going to show you what command you need to write in your CMD. Before that, you need to understand this thing that you need to install your ADB driver successfully in order to let your phone be discovered by your computer. So now you need to write this command, fastboot minus I 0 × 2B4C, then flash recovery. Now flash recovery. Now what you need to write is twrp.image, because it is the name of the file in my folder. So you need to write the name of the file in the which you just copied in this minimal ADB folder. After that you need to click enter. As I have done it before, I'm not going to flash it. So as you will click, write this command and click enter, your ADB TWRP will be flashed on your phone, and you will have successfully installed it. So now as I showed you how to do the TWRP process and vendor to factory, I'm going to show the normal process. Again, boot into TWRP and then go to install and just select these options which I did and flash them. And now what you need to do is go back and install. Click on install after selecting the selecting those two versions of AOS IP, AEX, sorry, it's AEX 6.3, and you need to select the Google Gaps, Open Gaps version 9.0, as it is based on Android Pie. So selecting both and flashing them up. So now you will be easily able to flash them on your Zeek Z2 Plus. So now I'm basically just going to show you a bit of this process, and I'm just going to skip some other process in between, because you know, actually it's the same process, it's a lengthy process taking about around 5 to 10 minutes, and I'm not going to show you all of that because you know, by cutting the process in between I'm going to save you some time. So I just skipped that part, and as you can see I just wiped it up, and now you need to select those both and swipe. So now your phone is going to reboot itself. So now while your phone is rebooting, you don't need to panic if it does not reboot after. Just wait for around 1 or 2 minutes, and if it does not reboot, what you need to do is click on your power button for around 15 to 20 seconds, and it is going to force reboot your phone, and it is a safe method if your phone doesn't reboot automatically. So as you can see, our phone has not rebooted up automatically, and what I need to do is I need to click on the power button, and as you can see, I'm just going to click on my power button to reboot my phone, to force reboot my phone in order to see how does it reboot. So actually, see, as you can see, our phone is now started, and it is going to start. So if your phone doesn't start automatically, what you need to do is you need to force reboot your phone by clicking on your power button for around 15 to 20 seconds, and it will force reboot your phone, and it is a safe method it is not like something, it is not something like your boot loops. It actually occurs sometimes, so you don't need to worry about it. What you need to do is just force reboot your phone, and it will be as normal as process as it is like when you flash other ROMs. So as you can see now that the AEX boot animation has appeared and it is loading. Now this loading process might take around 5 to 10 minutes depending on your first reboot. The second reboot might take around a minute or two, but the first reboot after flashing any custom ROM might take around 5 to 10 minutes. So wait for 5 to 10 minutes, put aside your phone, and you might notice, well, if you are going to flash any custom ROM on your phone for the first time, your phone is going to heat up a bit because it is a lengthy process and a bit of heavy task for your processor to do, as you are going to flash a new whole system, Android system, on your phone, and it will take some time to do it, and it is a heavy task for your processor to perform. So it will heat up your phone a bit, and you need to put aside your phone for around 2 to 3 minutes just to let it cool down. So you don't need to worry about it if your phone heats up directly after in flashing a custom ROM, because it happens with every other phone while you flash a new custom ROM on it. So now skipping to the main process, as you can see now, as our phone has started, and this is the end of this video. So as I told you in the earlier part of this video, you need to have a PC only for this one. So you need to have a PC, you need to flash the Neato TWRP and the vendor to factory zip file before flashing this ROM, and that's the end of this video. Please go subscribe and hit that bell icon, and please do comment down below which type of videos do you want to watch next, and thank you for watching.